What's up, everyone? All right, well, here we are. Today is day 14 of the Small Account Challenge, and I'm up another $3,000 this morning. So that means my account from 16,000, now tomorrow is gonna be up towards 19,000, probably around $19,500. And of course, the buying power is 19,500 times six. I have six times leverage, which means I can day trade with up to $120,000. And this is no longer a small account challenge anymore. Now the account is growing quickly. And that's the way it is with trading a small account. As it starts to grow, you can start to take larger and larger share size. Remember, the only difference between making 30 a day and then 300 and then 3,000 is increasing your share size. So during the first few days, weeks, or even months of trading with a small account, it can feel kind of like, man, $30 a day, that's not covering my bills, not covering my cost of living. But if you let that money roll over and you start to grow the account up, then you'll be able to afford to buy more shares. And then you can start scaling. And as you can see, you can scale very quickly if you've got the confidence. And that's a big part of it. It's having the emotional confidence to take larger share size, because of course, if the trades go the other way, well, you know, your risk and your loss is gonna be, of course, proportionally larger. I feel comfortable taking that risk. I'm at a place where I'm able to, you know, put the pedal to the metal and be aggressive, and here we are, 14 days from $500 to nearly $20,000. And the challenge isn't over yet. I've still got 3 days left. But at the end of the month, and at the end of the year, the end of the decade, this small account challenge will end. 2019, it's almost over. 2020 is around the corner. So what I want to announce for you guys is that we're doing a special priority access for a special New Year's Eve coupon code. Now what we're doing is we're going to email this coupon code to all of our existing students first. So all of our existing chat room, starter, and Warrior Pro students, they'll get the coupon code first. And there's a certain number of times the coupon code can be used. Once they've gotten the first dibs, then we're gonna open up that coupon code to students that are on the Priority Access email list. So traders like yourself that are following us on YouTube and Facebook, you guys can get on that list and you will get the second opportunity to use that coupon code until it expires. We are not gonna open up this coupon code to the general public. We're not gonna put it on the website. So the only way to get this special savings, a special discount, is if you're on the Priority Access list. Now, if you're watching this video in February, you're watching this in June or July of next summer, you can still register to the Priority Access list, because we do, you know, periodic things throughout the year for traders that are on that list. All right, we send you special things, little discounts and things like that. So if you are watching this down the road, you can still register Priority Access. It just won't help you for well, the sale that's happening right now. Okay, so Priority Access, you can check that out right down below. And I hope you guys enjoy the recap today. XRF, straight off the watch list. I mean, this stock was on fire. It was awesome. And, you know, another $3,000 progress is being made. So this small account challenge has been pretty exciting. And I'm going to take out my profits from December and start a new one in January. So I hope you're trading side by side with me for the next small account challenge. As always, if you have questions and comments during the recap, leave them down below. And I hope you guys like the video, give me the thumbs up, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. All right, enjoy the video, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. What's up, everyone? All right, so here we are, day 14 of the Small Account Challenge, and I'm up $3,461.63 this morning, and my account this morning had $16,392 in it, which means I'm up another 20% today, and tomorrow I'll be close to $20,000. I'll be well over 19,000, close to $20,000, and I still have 3 days left of the small account challenge. One, two, three. That'll be Friday, Monday, and Tuesday, and then the challenge is over. So now the question is, can I turn $500 into 25 grand in, well, let's see, 14, 15, 16, 17 days in 1 month of trading? And I think there's a good chance that I can do that. We'll see if the market is on my side. Obviously, I'm gonna need to continue to see some really great momentum, but if we do, then, you know, it might happen, and that'll be a pretty cool challenge. So, you know, but the thing with this challenge right now is that I've got $98,000 in buying power, right? Because it's 16,000 times six. I have six times leverage. So at this point, I can pretty much trade this account the same as I trade my big account.
Now, I don't trade it exactly the same because if I took a 10,000 share position and God forbid I lost $5,000 or $10,000, it would decimate my account. And so I don't actually trade it as aggressively, knowing that I could take a big loss, but I still trade it pretty aggressively, and I'm in really pretty nice shape here. So I want to show you guys a couple things. I want to show you the metrics of this small account challenge up through Tuesday. So I import my metrics the day after the trade. And those of you guys watching on YouTube and on Facebook, what I want you guys to do, right below, there's gonna be a link to register to Priority Access. So what I'm gonna do for New Year's Eve, New Year, New You, I've put together a special New Year's Eve coupon code, and it's gonna go for all of our existing students first. So all of you guys in the chat room, you don't need to register, you're already gonna get the coupon code to upgrade your membership from, you know, add another year, whatever the case is, depending on your membership level. Those of you guys on Facebook and on YouTube, if you register to the Priority Access list, after all of our existing students have had their first take at the coupon code, we'll email it to you guys. Now, we're not gonna post this coupon code on the website. It's a bigger discount than we did for Christmas. But for those of you guys that did join during Christmas, now that you're an existing student, you will get the first opportunity to use this coupon code to upgrade your subscription. If you wanna add another 3 months, 6 months, or a year, you can do that now. So make sure you guys register to Priority Access. Obviously, this is gonna be a pretty big sale that we're doing. It's New Year, New You, and this is always a really big one for us. So make sure you guys register if you haven't already. So now we're gonna go over the trades from today. XRF, TCCO, CANF, LQDA. Green across the board on 4 out of 4. Grabbed another winner in my main account, $4,600 on XRF. So total between the two accounts, I'm up like $8,000 today, which is solid. Really good, nice progress. It kind of started with a little bit of a bump in the road on XRF with my orders not getting filled. Now, these metrics here of the small account challenge so far, it's kind of interesting. The way they're imported is a little different when you do prop reports, which is what these are through CMEG, but accuracy 77%. $15,872 of total profit. Largest gain, that was on Tuesday on MBOT. The largest loss, which would be the stock that I closed the day red on, only $177. So right now, working with a great profit loss ratio, cutting my losses really quickly. And this is what I kind of want to keep doing. Wednesday, not going to have a lot of progress on Wednesdays because the first 2 weeks of the small account challenge were slow. And then I had one Wednesday where I didn't trade. And then Christmas, I didn't trade. And I won't trade on New Year's Eve or New Year's Day also. But anyways, those of you guys who are interested in the metrics, you can see them right there. So let's look at XRF. So this morning, this was our leading gapper, XRF, in the entire US market. So I can go time frame, historical date, and I'll do this for 9:20 a.m. All right, so what you're gonna see here, XRF gapping up 50%. Unfortunately, by the time the bell was ringing, it had already broken through the pre-market high of 3 and squeezed up to 359. So the bell rings and I said, all right, on this one, guys, I'm gonna just let it dip. And as soon as I start to see that buying coming in, I'm gonna punch the buy button. And so let me show you the video of this trade here. All right, so this is like so sad because here the bell has just rung. I'm watching, actually, let's go back here. All right, the bell's about to ring. So I see I've got my order ready at 374. I've got my hand on the buy button. I'm looking for a dip, and the second I see green, I'm gonna punch it. Red, red, green. So it's any of you guys who have done any street racing, you know what I'm talking about. When you see green, you punch it. And can you straight pipe a Honda Odyssey? You bet your butt you can. So I don't care if I'm lined up next to a Honda Odyssey or a Prius. When I see that light turn green, I'm pedal to the metal. So here we go, XRF. I see the green and boom, I hit it. unfortunately, on this one, you know, as you can see, I punched it and my order's just sitting there. This is the first time, actually it's the second time that it's ever happened with CMEG. This has happened before, generally speaking, in my trading, you know, career, that I've had trades at the bell that I've tried to, you know, punch the order and I don't get filled, and it is what it is. So anyways, I punched the order here. The second I saw green, my order's not going through, and I'm like, you know, what the heck? Obviously, the green is coming in. People are buying. And look at that, 385. So I punched the order for 4,000 shares. And now I'm like, all right, well, I better cancel it. You know, dang it. So I move my order up to $4. And I'm gonna click the buy button again. I'm thinking, okay, maybe that was just like a little lag in the first couple seconds. So I press it again. And again, it doesn't fill instantly. Now it should fill instantly. So now I'm like, okay, what's going on? So what I end up doing is I change my route from NASDAQ to ARCA. And when I changed my route, you know, I was able to get filled. So I ended up getting in this 50 cents higher. So here I switched to ARCA. This is the nice thing with direct access routing. If you do have an issue with one route, you can switch to a different one. And so I'm watching this. I think I did a smart route, didn't fill right away. So I was like, okay, I gotta switch back to ARCA. So I switched to ARCA. And then I see the green there and I punch it. Now that's actually a terrible fill, but whatever, it is what it is. It looks like it was 84, 84, and 74. So I'm punching it here. And then there we go, we get that quick break. And so from there, obviously the stock continues higher, and that was where I made the bulk of my profits. So we got this squeeze here on XRF up to, in the first 5 minutes, from 350 to 450 to 550, little pullback, and then up to six. You know, so on this, I sort of fumbled it, because on my first trade, it pops up to a high of 343. All right, so it goes up to 343, and I'm holding this trade here. I've got 2,000 shares from 383, and I'm holding through here. Let's see, where do I add? I was trading this in my big account also, so I added another 1,000 shares, as you can see there. So I thought it was going to break over 40. I added, and it hits. It's kind of now like churning right here, and I'm like, this isn't good. And now all of a sudden I realize my hotkey to exit, what if it doesn't work? Because we're having issues with routing. So what if my orders don't work? So I started to get worried that if my orders don't work on the exit, I could really be in a, you know, a situation where the stock could go down, you know, 30, 40, 50 cents a share, and I have a really big loss. So I decided, as it's starting to show a little weakness, I was like, you know what, let's just get out of this thing. So I got out, look at that. Isn't that so sad? I got out right there. And then that happened. That's the way it goes sometimes. So I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. So I ended up getting back in, right? Obviously I got back in. So I get back in here now for the break over five, and I start scaling up, and you know, I end up doing pretty well on it. I'll add again here for the move up from, I think it's 520 for a quick rip up to, so I'm back in here now for a quick rip up to 550. Now I'm sizing up a little bit more. There's 578. So this is gonna be the bigger trade for me, that move here up to six. But, you know, again, it's sort of, it's just one of those days where I happen to fumble at the starting gate. And, you know, it's sometimes hard to catch up from that. So I was up 3,000 on this. And then my last trade I took right here. I got back in right here thinking it was going to break over 550. And my average was about 525. And I stopped out at five. So on that last trade right through there, I gave back about 500. Maybe 600, and finished up only 2508. For those of you guys watching on Facebook. I'll just turn this around so you can kind of see where we're at. So this is my small account that I started this month with $500 right here on the left. So this account's up $3,461 versus my starting balance this morning of $16,000. And then this is my bigger account right here, which I'm actually not sure how much money I have in this account right now, but I took some money out and I'm gonna take more out as I kind of come to the end of the year. So this account probably has about $40,000 in it. So this account's up like 10% as well, which is some nice progress. So anyways, let's see. So that was XRF. Unfortunately, I was kind of watching it through this area to come back up through VWAP. I thought if it broke over 38, I would get back in. It did not end up breaking that level, so I did not take any more trades on it. You know, so a nice opportunity right out of the gates, but I kind of botched it a little bit. So that was XRF, our leading gapper in the entire market. We knew this one was going to be the one to trade at, you know, 920. So every single one of you guys who are in the chat room, you knew I was watching this one. And, you know, there's really no reason that you couldn't have been able to trade this side by side with me, and or even have better entries than me if you didn't have the order execution issue that I had. You know, and again, that's kind of my goal, is to make sure you guys know what I'm going to trade before I take the trade. So you're watching the stock, you're looking at it, you've got the chart up, the level two. And if you're trading in the simulator or with real money, you're able to do well. So speaking of simulator or real money and of doing well, let me put up this video. So I asked, of course, students in the chat room, I said, how'd you guys do on, how'd you do today? And Tristan, you can see here, he's up $846. The Warrior logo in the background, that means that he's trading in the simulator. So we have a simulator that we have white labeled with Sterling. Well, you know, it's not like we're, but we've, you know, branded it with our own logo and stuff like that. So he, they're in Sterling. Let me just play this video here. So let's see, a couple other traders will post their P&L. So John posted his $1,700 of profit. You've got another one right down here. Let's see, right there, $4,900. That's in the sim. Right here, that's a real money account for Eric, $2,300. Let's see. There's $320. That's a real money account for Moon. Jason, that's in the simulator, which is good. Ibrahim, he posted a red day, but he said later that that was the wrong screenshot. That was from a previous day of trading. And then he posted his screenshot for today. Jose, 2000, another student in the sim there. Let's see. There's Ibrahim's actual for today, 3,400. So that's good. That's nice to see. And, you know, again, it's just to goes to show that, you know, you guys are going through that journey of converting knowledge into a skill. One of the things that I say a lot is, just because you read a book on skydiving doesn't mean you've got the skill to jump out of an airplane. Just because you read a book on day trading, you know, obviously a lot of you guys have read the book that I wrote, doesn't equip you to trade. Just because you've watched a video, a YouTube video, doesn't mean that you're going to be able to trade profitably and make money. To convert that knowledge into a skill, you have to practice. And that's what the simulator is all about. You guys are able to practice real time each morning. Nice there from Ishmael, about $1,000, just under. So some really nice progress that I'm seeing from you guys who are in the chat room, making money and, you know, moving your way through the learning curve. All right. And of course, some of you guys have moved your way through the learning curve to the point that you're members of the 100K Club, meaning you've made over $100,000 of profit. We'll see. Let's see. Where was it? So there's Roberto, for instance. He's in the 100K Club. Ibrahim will probably be there pretty soon. John's in the 100K Club. Jess is there. And there's several others. But anyway, so I'll close this here. So that was XRF. The next stock was TCCO. Now TCCO, it was on the gap scanner, gapping up 9% today. I was a little cautious about it. I wasn't sure it was gonna work. The daily chart, it shows that it was a stock that had recently made a really big move. And so I thought, okay, you know, this may be one to watch. All of a sudden, it hits the high-day momentum scanner and starts surging up. And I thought, okay, you know what? I'm going to jump in it. So I bought it at $6. I jumped into this stock at $6. And then I add $6, and I think it was 15 cents or something like that. So it pops up here to six. It pops up a little higher. I add on this little pullback. It squeezes up. It hits 650 and then pulls back down to like 640. I go control Z. I sell my position. So I'm out. And then it pops back up to 648, 650. I punch the buy button again. I'm back in now with 1,000 shares at 650. It hits a high of 660 and then drops in this candle all the way to 540, which was a terrible drop. It pops back up here to 594 and I got out at the 590 spot. So I got out right around 588 and 590, which is certainly better than taking the loss at the very bottom, but it was disappointing to have given back that profit. And so after that trade, I started to think, this may be kind of it for the market. I'm not sure if I'm gonna continue to see good opportunities. CANF popped up kind of similarly right through here. I got in and then I got stopped out, came back down. I only made $140. Of course, it ends up ripping all the way up to 406 about 30 minutes later. LQDA, another one that hit the scanners. Kind of a strange one. It got halted at 505. So it squeezed up and got halted. It then resumed and squeezed up to 633 and got halted a second time. It then resumed. It pulled back for a second and I added for the break over 7. It squeezed up to 715. It then kind of hit some resistance there. I sold and then it dropped back down. So, you know, I made $193 on that with small share size because I didn't want to risk being too aggressive. At that point, I was like, you know what? My winners are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. We're not seeing these stocks continue to hold their breakouts. So I'm going to jump out and just take my profit on it. All right, so I'm gonna switch that to that side. All right, so that basically was, those were the four that I traded today. And in my big account, the only one I traded was XRF here, and that was out of the gate. So, you know, another pretty solid day. I'm hoping that we see this momentum continue into Friday. Awesome gap and go on XRF. That's straight out of chapter 5 and chapter 6 of the momentum strategies of the day trade course. So, really nice to see. And yeah, we've got three more days of 2019. And it's definitely time to start thinking about what the game plan is going to be for 2020. So as you guys know, I'm starting a new small account challenge in January, where I'm going to take out my December profits, and I'm going to start over. I have been thinking about how I'm going to do it and kind of what my plans are. I was considering doing a small account challenge where I don't use any margin or I don't use my leverage. I just trade my cash balance, starting with a little more cash, but only trading the cash balance. The thing that I'm feeling a little conflicted on is that I don't know how to set my account so I would only trade the cash balance. Like under settings, under my hotkeys, I can create a hotkey, for instance, to use 50% of my buying power. So since I have 6x leverage, I could choose to use 1/6 of my buying power in theory. However, this automatically adjusts based on the stock you're trading. So a stock that has no buying power available, well, because it's not marginable, it only gives you 50% of that amount. It knows that. So I have to think about that a little bit more because it would be right now just, it would require me to have to do the math before every trade of how many shares I can take. And that's not how I would want to trade or how I would think it would be smart to trade as a student. So I got to think about that a little bit in terms of the mechanics of how to do that. But it's a possibility. So I might do a non-margin type of challenge where I day trade a lot, but I don't use my leverage. Or I might just do another small account challenge similar to what I did in December. So I'm kind of thinking about it and going back and forth, but I will keep you guys posted. And in any case, those of you guys watching on YouTube and on Facebook, make sure you are registered to the priority access list so you get the coupon code for New Year's Eve email to you. We're not going to put that coupon code on the website. It's just going to be email only for existing students and those on the priority access list. All right, so make sure you guys are registered, and we're going to try to make 2020 an awesome year. New year, new you. So let's make it happen. All right, that's it for me. I'll see you guys tomorrow, and we'll finish up the week hopefully with a little bit more momentum and another green day. All right, I'll see you guys later. Bye, everyone.
Hey, did you know that I go live every single morning between 9 and 9:15 to stream my pre-market watch list? Subscribe to the channel, press the bell for the alert, and you'll get the notification.